this is the part I fucking hate the most. I am so angry. I'm not 100% sure what's caused all this. The last thing I remember was I was sitting in the kitchen and there was just one fly. And it just wouldn't leave me alone. Really? So of course I've cracked the shits and fucking gone into my makeup room because I thought there'd be no flies in there. Fly in there too, and as well I kicked my toe. So I thought I'd come out fine, like I had a breather, and I thought I'd come out fine, and then something happened again. I don't know what, I really don't. And then yeah, Nathan was saying something, and I'm asking for a Valium. That's what I need when I get like this. And he was getting it for me, but I didn't see him. Instead, he asked me a question if I'd already had my daily pills, as he always does whenever I get like this. And I just told him, fucking just please, just get my Valium. And then he lost his shit. Nothing bad happened. He just gets so frustrated with me. But then, yeah, I had my Valium and I don't know, I wanted to keep talking. And I can't talk because I've lost my voice, but I'm managing to talk to you just fine. So I screamed at him to fuck off. I just downed full Valium. It should be working by now, but it's not. So I screamed to fuck off, and now he's out of the shed. And yeah, out of the full Valium, and I calmed down and went back out there to apologize for whatever the fuck I did wrong. Fuck, this is so hard. I don't even know if I'm gonna post this. But I just went out there to apologize, and he's gone, why are you out here? And just the tone. I'm like a ballsy nut to come out to apologize for what I think I did wrong, or I don't even know. And then, oh, just so angry. And you guys wanted to know what it's like to have bipolar. Welcome to my life. So, I'm not 100% sure what's caused all this. The last thing I remember was I was sitting in the kitchen and there was just one fly. And it just wouldn't leave me alone. So of course I've cracked the shits and fucking gone into my makeup room because I thought there'd be no flies in there. There's a fly in there too, and as well I kicked my toe. So I thought I'd come out fine, like I had a breather, and I thought I'd come out fine, and then something happened again. I don't know what, I really don't. And then, yeah, Nathan was saying something. And I asked him for a Valium. That's what I need when I get like this. And he was getting it for me, but I didn't see him. Instead, he asked me a question if I'd already had my daily pills. as he always does whenever I get like this. And I just told him to me. Yeah, I had my Valium and I don't know, I wanted to keep talking and I can't talk because I've lost my voice, but I'm managing to talk to you just fine. So I screamed at him to fuck off. I just downed full Valium. It should be working by now, but it's not. So I screamed at him to fuck off and now he's out in the shed. And me and I had the full Valium and I can't down on my back out there to apologize for whatever the fuck I did wrong. Hard. I don't even know if I'm gonna post this. But I just went out there to apologize and he's gone, "Why are you out here?" And just the tone. I'm like a ballsy nut to come out to apologize for what I think I did wrong when I don't even know. And then, oh, just so angry. And you guys wanted to know what it's like to have bipolar. Welcome to my life. So what happened?
You were trying to eat your lunch, and there was a fly that kept buzzing around you. And they kept buzzing around you. So you lost your shit at the fly. And then one of the dogs jumped up. And you lost your shit more. And then you went into the room. And you had a fly annoying you in there. And then you kicked your toe. And then you come out and you were already well and truly well on your way to going off. So then you asked me to get you a Valium. And while I was in getting your Valium, because it was in the same packet as your normal everyday meds, I asked if you'd had one of them, and you thought that it was me not getting you Valium.
Yeah.
So then you lost your shit further. And next thing was you telling me to fuck off. So I grabbed my smokes and I walked out the back and I went and sat and had a smoke. And I walked out in the shed and started doing other stuff because, like you already know, I'd only had maybe 4 hours of sleep. So I was doing everything I could not to fire. So I went out in the shed and started to do something. And then you came out. And I basically said, "Well, what are you doing out here?" And you sort of looked at me and sort of went, well, the look was,
"Yeah, with that face.
What the fuck do you think I'm doing
here?"
And I said, "Look, it's all good. You can go back inside. I'll be in after." And then you were sort of, "Whatever," and you walked in and I could hear you slam the door and carry on and I'm like, "You'll cool off." So I just kept plodding along doing what I did because me having a lack of sleep as well, I wasn't going to get dragged into it. I'm smarter than that.
So that started all over a fly?
Yeah.
There was nothing before that?
Nothing I can think of. That's why it didn't make, that's where I struggle the most, just to see it, is when it's something so small, so minute to anybody else. Like that fly that was bothering you, it wasn't just bothering you. Like it landed on my lip while I was trying to eat my kebab.
Really?
Yeah.
Jesus.
So, like I said, what doesn't seem like much to anybody else can have a huge swing on you like there's no tomorrow.
I just can't believe that all of that, like even the bit before I started recording, because I started recording basically after
you already had your spasm.
The minute.
Yeah.
And then I'm like, no, I want to record this, whether it was to post it or even just to look back and see how I react through it all. I'm just a fly. And I was up to date on my meds.
Yeah, but you've had We've had a massive week. We've done, what, 65, 70 hours. Haven't been to bed before midnight most nights. Up at 6:30 every morning. You just need a break. You're getting shorter and shorter, and that's all it is you're getting run down.
Well, there you go.
Yeah, most people when they get run down, they get sick. You get run down and you just get short tempered. And your bipolar episode swing.
I was just hoping there would have been a little bit more insight rather than me just cracking my banana because of a fly.
It's what's called intermittent explosive disorder, mate. Yeah? We've seen how small of a thing it can go off on.
Just mental.
Yeah. Mental health.
Interesting. Think about that for a bit. Don't judge me. I don't want to hear your thoughts. Just